Hello everybody and welcome back to another Blender Mini tutorial. Today we're going to be creating a text explosion effect using a particle system, some texturing, and just some other little tricks and techniques that I've figured out. Okay, so currently I'm in the build 2.79 and this version has denoising. It has a couple new features that are going to be coming out in the official build 2.79. So if you don't have the build, go download that. Link is down in the description. So first off, I'm going to delete this cube by pressing X and delete it. Then we're going to add in some text. So press Shift A, we're going to go to text right here. Then I'm going to rotate this text 90 degrees. So press R, X, and 90, and enter. Now press Tab, and this is where you can enter in your own text. You can do whatever you want. I'm just going to leave it as text, all capitals. And then I'm going to add an extrusion effect, so this has some thickness. So go over to the object data panel for our text, and this extrude value, we just need to turn that up just a little bit, maybe like 0.1 is probably good. There we go. Scale up the text just a little bit so it's a little bit bigger. Now we're going to convert this into a mesh, but before you do that, you should always try to duplicate your object, because if you apply a modifier or do anything like that, you should always duplicate it just so you have a backup if you need to go back to that. So Shift E, right click, then press M and move it to a trash layer. I'm just going to go layer 5, that's the one that I usually do. Now right click on your text and convert it to a mesh. You can do that by pressing Alt C and go Mesh from Curve Meta Surf Text. Now if we go into edit mode, we can see this has vertices now. But you can zoom in here and you can see the geometry is terrible. There's like lines going this way, there's doubles, and it's really bad. So we need to fix our geometry for the explode modifier to work properly. So to do this, go over to the modifier tab and add in a remesh modifier right here. Now if we turn this on, this happens. And we need to turn up the resolution, and we also need to uncheck remove disconnected pieces. So uncheck that and then turn up the octree depth. I found like a value of 7 works perfectly fine. If we press Z, we can see the geometry, and I think that looks good. So apply that modifier. And now if we go into edit mode, the geometry is much better. Everything looks really good. Now we can start using the particle system. So come down to Object, Quick Effects, and Quick Explode. Now currently, if we go over to the particle system, we can see the effects that have already been set in. The end frame and the start frame, it starts at 1. So if we press Alt A, everything explodes just like that. What we need to do is turn the start and end frame to a different value. The end frame, I'm going to set it to 70, and the start frame, I'm going to set it to 20. So over 50 frames between 20 and 70, this text will explode. So now if I press Alt A, we can see it explodes, and once it hits 70, everything has exploded. I'm going to turn up the number of particles to around 1,000, maybe 500. Let's go with 1,000 first and see how that looks. So Alt A. And yeah, that looks much better. There's a lot more particles and I think it looks better. So that is good. What we're gonna do now is add in a texture for our particles to actually follow like a color ramp sort of thing. And I'll show you what I'm talking about. So go down to the texture panel down here in the particle system and click new. Now head over to the texture panel, and this is where we can set up all this cool stuff. Change the type to blend. And if we press Alt A, we can see it kind of working, but not really. So what we need to do is go over to colors and check on ramp. Now, once we add in the ramp, this is really transparent. It's fully transparent. So we need to make this a complete black. So turn up the alpha all the way up. Let's see what happens if we press Alt A. It's still not working. There's still a couple over here that aren't getting disintegrated. So press Shift A, add in a mesh and plane. This plane is going to act like a kind of like a ruler or a guide sort of for the texture. So we're going to scale it up along the X so it matches this. So place it right in the middle, then press S, X, and scale it up till it's about the size of the text and move it into place right about there. Then press S, Y, and scale it down just a little bit, and then drag it above the text. You don't have to worry where it's going to be placed, so we're going to turn it invisible in just a second. But for now, we'll just leave it there. And look down at your name down here. It's called plane, so try to remember that. Right click on our text. We need to come down the coordinates on our texture. We need to change it to object. Then in the object, we need to set it to the plane that we just added, which is plane right here. So now once we play this, we can see. Okay, so if you're having the problem where some particles are still over here when the others disappear, that might be because we need to do a couple settings. So first off, the linear, the ramp, I need to change this to ease. So it's a little bit more of an ease throughout. And let's play this again and see how that looks. You can still see it's not really working. But what I noticed is we just have to play it a couple times, then it seems to work. So if you're having that trouble, if you're having that problem, just play it a couple times and then it should work. There we go. That seemed to work perfectly fine. There, that is it right there. Okay, so then come over to your particle system. I want to do a little bit of settings here. So first off, the lifetime, I want the particles to last a lot longer. So I'm gonna go 250 on the lifetime. I'm also gonna change the end frame to 100 instead of 70 because I want this to last just a little bit longer. So let's go back, play that one more time and see what that looks like. And there we go. Great. So now we're gonna add in a plane for the particles to fall on. So press Shift A, we're gonna go to Mesh and Plane, go into Front View, bring the plane below the text and scale it up. Then go over to the physics settings and add a collision for the physics. Now we need to do some settings over here. First off, the particle dampening. This is for the bounciness of the particles. If we play this, you'll see what I'm talking about. The particles bounce like crazy. I'm gonna turn up the dampening to like 0.6. The friction, I'm gonna turn up to a value of like 0.3. We'll also give this some random as well. So now we'll play that and see what that looks like. There we go, look at that. That looks pretty cool. But another thing that we need to do is add a solidify modifier, because if we play this one more time and zoom in here, you can see that these parts, these little like particles are very, very thin. They're paper thin. So we need to add a solidify modifier right here, and that should do it. So let's play that and see what that looks like. There we go. Look at that, much, much better. Very cool. I think we're good to go. So now we're gonna set up some lighting, do some rendering, and see what it looks like. So this lamp, I'm just gonna turn it to a sun lamp, and I'm gonna rotate it so it's facing the text right there. Place it there, rotate it a little bit, up a little bit, and there's probably good. Next, I'm going to position the camera. So position it right about here. Control Alt 0 to snap it into place. I'll right click on it and I'll drag it back. Just place it somewhere around here is probably good. And we'll press Alt A, see what it looks like. Nice. There we go, great. Now, another thing that we need to do is right click on our plane because I don't want this to show up in the render. So go over to the cycle settings, this little object data panel, come down to the cycle settings in the bottom and turn off camera, shadow. You can just turn off all of these actually because I don't want this to show up at all for any of these. I'll press Shift Z and there we can see it's gone. The material, you can do whatever you want. I think I'm gonna go with like a mix shader, maybe like a blue color, something like that. So we'll go mix, I'll set it to diffuse and glossy right here. I'll turn down the factor to a value of like 0.2 maybe. I'll turn the roughness on the glossiness a little bit down. So yeah, it gives it a cool smooth effect. And then I'll give it like a blue color somewhere around there. We'll see what that looks like. That looks pretty good. I think the factor might be a little high, so I'll turn that down. There we go. So let's play this and we'll stop it like right about here. And that looks pretty cool. The plane, I'm gonna give this a glossy shader right here, glossy, and the roughness I'm gonna go with a value of 0.05, and Shift Z to see what that looks like. You know what, I don't really like that. I think I'm just gonna go with a mix shader. So mix, diffuse, and glossy, and I'll turn, no, not glass, glossy, I'll turn the roughness all the way down and the factor I'll go with 0.2. yeah, I think that's better because then we can see some reflections, but it also is a little bit white. The background, I'm gonna turn that up so it's a more of a white color. And I think we're good to render. So we'll do some render settings. Come over here, I'm gonna turn the sampling to a value of like 35. And I'm also gonna turn on the indirect to a value of 1, because if we zoom in here, there were a little bit of fireflies over here. So I'll turn that up to 1, I think that'll be good. Light paths, I'll turn off reflective and refractive. and then I'll also turn on denoising, and I think we're good to go. Next thing that you're going to want to do is create a folder on your desktop and then set the output over here. So just click on this button and select the folder that you just created. Mine is right here, pictures, and accept. So now once we do the animation render, all of the images will go into this folder. The resolution, I'm going to go with a value of 1280 by 720 with 100% resolution. That should be good. And the end frame, we'll play this and just see where we want to end it. Right there is probably good. So let's go with a value of like 125. So it's not a super long animation, but it's right about there. Great. Okay, so save your project by hitting Control S. We'll save it to my desktop. I'll just call it Explosion Effect. And we're ready to render. So hit animation and this will render it out. This should not take too long. It should go pretty fast. And then we'll see what it looks like. Okay, the render is finished and now we're going to sequence it out. So to do this, come down to this menu and click on Video Sequence Editor. Click on Add Image and navigate to where your images are. Mine are right here. Then press A to select everything and go Add Image Strip. We'll see this pop up and all we have to do now is change it to a movie file. I'm going to go MPEG. The encoding, I'm going to go MP4. And the codex is H.264. Yep, that's good. Output quality, I'll go with high. And animation. So that will sequence it out and we'll be able to view it in real time. Now the animation will be in the folder that you specified right here in the output, or you can come up to render and go play rendered animation. So I'll do that real quick and this will pop up. Just give it a second. There we go. And there's our animation. Look at that. We'll watch it one more time. There it is. So that is it, guys. That is the tutorial. Thank you for watching. If you learned something new or if you made a cool image, I'd love to see it. So make sure to post it on Twitter and all that fun stuff. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next tutorial.